right, thank you. All right, well.
It's another Monday.
Yeah, we're pretty late today, so forgive us for that. We had some circumstances that got us, that we had to start later. And so that means, hey, you only had to deal with us only for not as long, you know. You know, you only deal with it for a little while this time. So we'll be up here for
a few minutes.
We'll be off here before 12 o'clock, you know. So, and then you can go have your lunch and enjoy the rest of your day and everything. I hope you're enjoying 12. Your day already. Huh? Before 12. Well, it's 11:24. We try to do a 30-minute show.
We're supposed to end at 12. So.
We try to do a 30-minute show since we started late. Don't want to go over 12 o'clock and everything. I just figured we'd be done by 12 since we got things that we have to do today. Amen. But I do want to say this, though. I do want to remind you this, though. They said never point, because when you point at somebody else, you got, three more fingers pointing back at you.
It's the wrong thing.
Okay, I want to make sure that everything got right. But at the same time, as we get ready to enjoy this nice day, some of y'all been out in it already. You know, some of y'all been going out. Some of y'all actually about to take lunch. Some of y'all maybe on your lunch. Whatever it is, I do want to remind you this. This is something you need to be reminded of. You need to remind yourself of. You need to say this to yourself. You need to look in the mirror. Sometimes you need to go into your own mirror. The Bible says David encouraged himself in the Lord. Yes. And David came and David went and David said something like this. David would say stuff like this. I would have fainted unless I have believed to see the goodness of God in the land of the living. Stuff like that. He would say stuff like that in different things. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall be continually in my mouth. Now, what we need to do is we need to remind ourselves, and sometimes you should try this, and you should try this. At first, you may feel funny, but it really don't make me feel funny. But some people say you feel weird, some awkward, but this is what you need to do sometimes. Look in the mirror and look in the mirror at yourself in the morning while you're getting ready. After you brush your teeth, say you're washing your face or you're putting your face cream on and before you rinse it off, and you're giving it that time that you let it do whatever it do while before you rinse it off. Look in the mirror or something like that and look in the mirror and talk to yourself and tell yourself this, that you are who the Word of God says you are. You can do what the Word of God says you can do, and you can have what the Word of God says you can have. This is Paul and
Tara
Thompson, and you're watching Advancing the Kingdom. That's what you need to do. Tell yourself, I am who the Word of God says I am.
Yes.
I can do what the Word of God says I can do, and I can have what the Word of God says I can have. The Word of God is your inheritance. The Word of God is, it tells you what is yours, that you have a right to it. I love this, that my covenant I will not alter, nor what I mean my covenant I will not break, nor alter the words that have, or the thing that has gone out of my lips. God will do what he said, and he stands on his word. And so you stand on his word, and so you are who the Word of God says you are. So you're not what other people said you are, unless it's according to the Word of God. So you are who the Word says you are. So that's how you need to conduct yourself. That's how you need to think of yourself. That's how you need to act. That's how you need to speak based on who the Word says you are, not how you feel about yourself. You can feel so many ways about yourself. I mean, you can feel a lot of ways about yourself. You can look at your situation. I mean, some of you all may have the fight thoughts like, I feel like I'm a loser. I feel like, you know, I'm not a man. I feel like I'm not a, you know, a woman. I feel like I'm this or that. Sometimes back in the, you know, nowadays, women seem like they don't really care about having kids, because everybody had kids and kids everywhere. But I remember one time some women, I would say, not being able to have children will make me feel less than a woman. Yeah. Like this is the thing that makes me distinct, the thing that makes me unique, that I can have children. And that's the one thing I can't do.
Yeah.
And so that
I remember when the doctors told me I wouldn't be able to have, I had two, but they said I wouldn't be able to have any more. And expecting to be married, that was a big deal, because I felt like, you know, I mean, we weren't an item yet, but I felt like when I got married, I was gonna then want to have, you know, more children. I always wanted a big family. And so I felt like, you know, so God, what's up? You know, the heathens, they just popping them out like, you know, like. And so now that I've become a believer, you mean to tell me I become a believer and now I can't have any more? What's up with that? And so, yeah, it was, that was a big thing to me. That was. And but yeah, I don't think that's a big thing to women now. All right, go ahead.
It don't seem like it. It don't seem like it.
To some women, I'm sure it is.
But, yeah, but yeah, some either some women act like they don't care or whatever. But
yeah,
it don't seem like it is. But I tell you, even though the doctors may say you can't have a child, and say you want to have a child, and you fighting the feelings of I'm not even useful as a woman. I can't even have a child. Ooh. I can't even get pregnant.
Yeah, that's
and
a natural
those
thing.
Are thoughts that will go through your head. Those are feelings that you will feel. Ooh. Because it seems like you can't do the thing you think.
Oh, he's having a moment.
You should be able to. No, seriously. But
hit him right now.
But you should. But it makes no difference. Even if you should be able to, have children and can't, you still who the Word of God says you are.
That's right.
You still can do what the Word of God says you can do. Now, the thing about it is, the Word of God says something like this. It says all things are possible to them that believe.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can do what the Word of God says you can do the impossible. You
That's
can
right.
receive the impossible because the Word of God says all things are possible to right. them that believe.
Mm-hmm.
So that means everything now that you can't do in the natural becomes doable.
Yeah.
And so it's all about you reminding yourself. It's all about reminding yourself yeah. that you are who the Word of God says you are.
Yeah.
That you can do what the Word of God says you can do, and you can have what the Word of God says you can have. Since we always talk about that, that's something, I guess, let's hit that right quick.
Yeah.
That and I do want to say this, that on Sunday mornings at 11 o'clock, Global Harvest, we have our Sunday morning services at 2926 East Washington Street, 11 a.m. We would love to have you there.
Yes.
Wear your mask, sanitize at the door, and be happy and come and receive.
Yes.
I am who the Word of God says I am.
Yes, I am.
And I remember when it was during the time you gave me that, did you give me the book or did you? It's around the time when, it was right before we started talking. I don't know if you gave me a book or about the righteousness, you are the righteousness of God. Or if it was that card that you gave me that says not by might, not by power, you wrote.
Okay.
In there. And during that time,
before we dated, we were friends.
I started listening, reading books by not Joel, but John Osteen. The dad. And John Osteen had a book out called You Are the Righteousness of God. And John Osteen, he broke it down in that book about who I was. It was a small book, a mini book, nice yeah. little mini book about
I
who you are.
Books.
and I read that book. Yeah. I read it. I just read that thing. And it hit me that, you know, I am the righteousness of God in Christ.
Mm-hmm.
That it's not, I don't have to try to be, it's just I am.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll never forget after that, I started finding out that if I wanted to find myself, that I can find myself in the Word.
In the Word, yeah.
And anywhere in the Word where it says in Christ, anywhere in the Word where it says in whom, anywhere in the Word that is that talks about in Christ and in whom and as a believer and a believer, it's talking about me.
Yeah.
That I am in the Word.
Yeah.
You listen, y'all, you are in the Word. I know a lot of people, I said this before, a lot of y'all say, man, you got people that, you can't compare yourself to Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph. Listen, it's Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph, listen, Jesus, and Donnie. That's how you got to look at it. Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph and Tara, Abraham, I mean Jesus and Tara, that's Abraham, right. Isaac, Jacob, that's Joseph, sure. Jesus, and you. Yes. You gotta look at it. You're part of the lineage. You're part, yes, of the family. You have just as much value to God, yes, as Adam, uh-huh, Eve, Moses.
Yes.
You hear me? Elijah, Elisha, all of them. And the Bible lets you know, Elijah, he had like passions just like us. Mm-hmm. There's nothing different. We're human, that's beings. Right. The difference is that they may believe something you didn't believe, or they may was obedient in areas you may not be obedient. Sometimes it's not that a person has more faith. They may have more obedience. And so it's, ooh, important to realize, listen, that you are who the Word of God says you are. In order for us to do what the Word of God says for us to do, and in order for us to have what the Word of God says for us to have, and that we can have, we got to come to the conclusion that we are who the Word of God says we, yeah, are. Yeah. I won't say the name because I think they may be on and everything, but it was this person that said that they have a, they told us yesterday, and you'll know who you are if you listening. You told us that they, you know, hey, I have an insecurity problem, mm-hmm, about themselves. They got a self problem about how they feel about themselves or whatever, for whatever reason, and what that does is that gives us a perverted distortion about ourselves.
Yeah.
Because whenever you're not looking at yourself and thinking about yourself the way God thinks about you, it's a distortion, and you're supposed to be looking at yourself and thinking about yourself, not conceitedly and arrogantly and fleshly like you may think you should think, but no, you should be thinking of yourself and viewing yourself the way God sees you.
Mm-hmm.
And the way that God sees you is this: you have to go. Maybe sometimes we don't receive. Maybe it's because we don't know who we are.
Right, I believe that.
And so if you say I am who the Word of God says I am, so that means you got to know who you are.
Right, right. And I think, I mean,
identity.
When you don't have, well, you have to identify with the Word.
Mm-hmm.
You have to identify with who the Word. And I think sometimes we are so used to identifying with our old
self. I'm trying to break it down to sudden.
we don't identify with that person in the Word. We identify with who we've seen, mm-hmm, and who we've heard that we are so long. We just don't recognize ourselves in the Word because we're like, who is that? Mm-hmm. That's not me. Mm-hmm. And we don't know that. We've not been told that. We've not been taught that. We've not heard it. We've not seen it.
You remember we've been taught stuff like we just worms and you know God don't need you. You just you better watch out because you'll be a greasy spot. God, yep, burn you up.
God'll kill you.
Yeah, and you
learn that in church.
Yeah, I'm just a little,
for
woe
such
me,
a
you know,
word,
yeah.
As I, that was the verse that I kept learning about at the cross. Oh my gosh.
So that
verse stuck out for such a worm.
The church got us and is viewing us and is viewing themselves as worms.
Yeah.
But we're the body of Christ.
Yeah.
We're not the bride of Christ according to the scriptures. Technically, the New Jerusalem is, but we're the body of Christ.
Yes.
We're the body of Christ. We're the believers. You are a believer. And this thing about it, I was thinking about what scriptures to go to and what to talk about and what scriptures to read. But it's almost like this: for me to read one scripture, it's almost going to do an injustice to every other scripture that we, in the sense that you can't find one. It's so many scriptures in here. And it's like this: every scripture that says in him, in whom, every scripture that says about a believer, you are in the Word, and you have to begin to look at yourself, yes, based on the Word and look and check on your identity. Watch this. You are the light. You are. See, I know people are like, I'm a light in the world. Yeah, you are light in the world. The Bible says we are the lights of the world.
Mm-hmm.
You are light of the world. You are salt. And you're a city on the hill. Jesus said this, that sits on the hill. Watch it. Let me read what Jesus said about us right quick.
Every time notice religion will have you every time you try to say who you are, and if it sounds like you're too great, They try to hurry up and humble you and break it down. You know, you're the light of the world. Well, now watch it now. I mean, you know, we're the light bearers. We're not the light. I mean, they just try to bring it down so fat like it's, ooh, you know. And I understand not thinking too highly of yourself. That people will make sure you know that verse.
Yeah, make sure they humble you.
Yes. And I mean, like, who put everybody in charge of the, you know, who's on the humility council?
Right. I'm blessed. Yeah, I mean, only in Jesus. We know that. You like,
who did? God did not put them, he didn't put anybody in charge of that.
So because we read everything in the condemnation mentality.
Yes, so it's perverted. We're still not reading it with the right mindset because we are still not reading it correctly.
We're not reading it in righteousness.
Right. And so we still don't have the right. We're not identifying correctly. We don't have the right. We don't know who we are.
Yeah.
We're reading words, but we're not getting it. We don't know who we are. Because when we know who we are, I'm telling you, ain't no way you can keep a frown on your face and really know who you are. I'm telling you, anybody that's ever been depressed, I have been depressed, y'all. Depressed. Where you sad and it seemed like the sunshine, you'd be like, hey, the sun ain't shining. I don't care, it's shining. I mean, saved and depressed. Well, I ain't even going into the details, but I'm saved and felt depressed. That's why I put it like I felt depressed. Heaviness on me. But when I began to really focus on who I was, who I really am, not how I felt, but who I am, huh?
I was reading that.
Oh. When I began to focus on who I am in Christ, not how I felt, not what was going on, not the stuff that was coming at me, but who I am and what Jesus did for me, and I began to focus on that, I'm going to tell you what. It began to break through that darkness, but I had to focus on that and really go back to my identity. And it will make you shake yourself and be like, wait a minute, you really do have that prodigal son moment. Like, wait a minute, wait a minute. You just want to slap yourself like, wait a minute, what am I doing here? What am I, hold up. Why sit ye here and die? Why am I sitting here like this? Why am I so down? It really will make you wake up and be like, hold on. I'm not, why am I dealing with, no, get up off me. You cannot stay down when you begin to think about who you are. When you go back to it and you realize, wait a minute, who am I? You can't stay there. You cannot. You can't. You can't stay sick. Your body might have some symptoms and stuff going on, but your soul will not. Your soul will get up out of it.
Who you are is not in the flesh.
Right.
You know, when you talk about when you say, who am I? Your identity.
Yes.
Your identity is not this. Your flesh. Too long, our flesh has been our identity.
Yes, yes, yes.
And the natural realm has been our identity.
Yes.
So therefore, it's easy to get depressed.
Yes.
When you straight up just looking at your natural situation.
Yes, yes.
Depression is easy.
Yes,
but,
yes,
and,
it is.
And in the natural, when you look at your natural self and look at the flesh, that's not the real you.
Right.
That part of you is going to go back to the dust of the earth and everything. And then one day you have glorified body. Your spirit is all about who you are in the spirit, number one, because your spirit man is going to live forever and your spirit man lives through your body. So you, in order for your body to express its true identity, your spirit must have the revelation.
Mm-hmm.
In order for your body to express your true identity, your spirit must have the revelation of who you are.
Yes.
So your spirit man must have the revelation, I am healed.
Yes.
No matter if you're on a bed in a coma, your spirit is healed.
Yes.
If you're broke and sitting in a box, Your spirit is prosperous.
Yes.
Your spirit, if you're crying and in grief, your spirit is in joy, still has
That's
joy.
Right. That's right.
Even though it's a grievous natural situation, your
yes.
spirit is not participating in
yes.
the natural events. Your spirit is hooked up with God and is in the spirit realm. Now we got to get on the right frequency.
Right.
We're on the
right,
on the right. See let's say we got three frequencies. We got a flesh frequency.
Yes.
We have a soul
yes.
frequency. Mind, will, and emotions, where y'all emotional and all that type of stuff, where I feel it, that
what
and
I
then
think it is.
Thirdly, you have a spirit frequency.
Uh-huh.
And most of the time we're on this flesh and this soulish frequency.
Yes.
And
that's
we're
right.
dialed into there.
Yes.
And we look at ourselves
so in tune
and
with
identify
those.
With the flesh
yes.
frequency and the soul
and the
frequency.
Soul.
We identify with how we feel.
Yes.
I mean, I don't feel like it. We done got used to that. I don't feel like it. I mean, I don't feel prosperous. You know, it don't look like I'm blessed. It don't look like things working out. But in the spirit, the Bible says we live by faith. So your spirit man is like, yeah, I'm triumphing. I am this. In Christ, I'm all this. What is in Christ? Your flesh is not in Christ. Your spirit man is in Christ. If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Your
yes.
flesh did not become a new creature. If you were bald when you got saved, sinner, you were bald when you got saved. If you ugly when you were saved, unsaved, you probably ugly while you're saved. But now he beautifies and meets with salvation. And now you look better.
And all the ugly people rejoice. Hallelujah.
If you was a man when you were saved, unsaved, you was a
Come
man
on.
When you're saved.
Well,
and nowadays, I thank God, whatever. All right.
Oh.
Listen to what it says. Hmm. Jesus said in Matthew 5:13.
That's another broadcast. We'll
yeah, because
well,
if you're confused about who you are, get in Christ, and he will make it very, 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 very sure. If you're confused about who you are, watch this. I can help everybody that have an identity problem. Everyone with an identity crisis about, am I male or female? Look at your equipment. Look at your equipment and it will tell you if you're a man or if you're a woman. Now, how you feel don't matter because God gave you the equipment of whatever gender you are. And so then people say, I don't feel this. I don't feel that. And they started with the seed, that thought, that seed started to germinate and started to grow. So then it become a full out confusion of
yeah.
who am I? And they have an identity crisis. That it will work the same way in every other area of
yes.
your life. It will start out, who am I? Or am I really blessed? Or blessed? Or I mean, why God not doing this? Why I don't have the money?
Mm-hmm.
Why I'm not rich? No. You can't allow the seeds of those things to get in there
yes.
and your feelings to get you off into thoughts that's going to mess you up. Just because
yeah.
I don't feel blessed or I don't feel this way don't mean nothing.
Right.
We the just shall live by faith, not feelings. Jesus said in Matthew 5:13, 14, 15, and 16, that you are the salt of the world. And if it says, if the salt lost its savior, it's good for nothing.
Savor,
yeah, it's good for nothing. And then he says, you are the light of the world. And he says, you're a city set on the hill that cannot be hid. You're
mm-hmm.
supposed to be, God wants to show you off.
Yes.
but why he going to show off a city that don't even know it's a city?
Mm.
You trying to hide your light. You trying to
yeah.
hide, and God trying to cause
Constantly
us to
get, trying to cover it
He's
up.
Trying to show us off.
Yes.
But he's not going to show off somebody that don't know who they are.
That's right.
And then he says, you know, he says, because men do not put candles under a bushel, and they don't, you know, put a candlestick
That's
in the house
right,
so
Linda.
It can't be seen. You are the light of the world. He says, let your light shine before men that people may see your good works and glorify
mm-hmm.
God. God want people to see you
see.
And
yeah.
see you and you must know who you are. I'm going to read this very familiar scripture to you.
You're and right, Linda. It's a feeling. It'll pass.
All feelings
change.
Go by. I mean,
they vacillate.
Just wait a while. It will just like, okay, people say, man, I don't like most emotions, all the emotions and all this stuff come from feelings. That's it. You feel a certain way about a person and it could be a strong feeling. You get that hate or that offense mm-hmm. that it be there. But, you know, hey, just don't go with it. Just wait. It'll go away.
Mm-hmm.
The thing about it is this. You got to learn how to overcome your emotions and your feelings. If you don't unlearn to overcome your feelings and your emotions, all of a sudden those things are going to sway us, and it's going to mess up out of our faith. It's going to mess up us in everything, because now you got to take dominion over your feelings, and you got to say, no, that's not who I am. That's not, you know, no, I'm not a feeling.
I'm not a feeling.
No, I'm not a feeling, and I'm not a thought. Mm-hmm. So when that thought, when that bad thought, like for instance, I'll never forget a thought, a thought came. Look at that lady's big butt. That wasn't my thought, because I don't think like that. That was the devil putting that thought in my head. Now, some people say, I got to get purged, boy, because I thought, look at the big butt, you know, and everything. And I thought it. So, oh, Lord, yeah. I pray, Lord, deliver me from that thought.
Cheryl,
see, that's sin consciousness. Mm-hmm. That's not righteous consciousness.
Right.
I'm righteous, so therefore I don't think about sin. I don't think sin. I don't think that type of way. So therefore, if all of a sudden some female walked by, and all of a sudden the thought come, just look at that big old butt and everything, I'd be like, what? Get out of my mind. Devil, give me, that's not my mm-hmm. thought. I don't think that way. And Jesus, I go by my way. Well, what do you do? I just go by my way. I don't care. Why would I turn and look at the butt? And everything, it's just a butt that's just bigger than mine or somebody else's. That's all it is a butt. You know, that's it. And they be doing the butt, whatever. But it's just a butt. I just, you know, it's just a butt. It's whatever.
So
instead of me doing, some people I go, oh Lord. And so I seen men fighting not to look. I'm like, dude, is that bad for you? And so some people, it is really bad. They just be wanting to look. They're like, I mean.
Yes.
It's not
yes.
that deep. I mean, you can't do nothing with it right there. I mean, it's whatever. Just whatever. Go by your way. You know, they married and everything. Go by. Just go. And the thought come, look at that big old butt. And I just keep on going. I just say big old butt because that.
You have a lot of
because of the song I thought about. It. Cheryl, you look at that big old
butt. So, got a big old butt.
But see, that's not my fault. And that's why I say that ain't my thought. I go by my way in Jesus' name. And I don't look. I don't be looking. I don't go around looking at females' butts. So therefore, watch this. I know that's not my fault.
Sorry, Linda. Sorry.
So I'm not going to be feeling, I'm not going to feel condemned because that's not my, I don't go around thinking that way. You get what I'm saying? The thought comes, cuss this person out. I don't cuss. I don't cuss when I'm mad. I don't cuss when I get angry.
No.
I don't cuss, you know. I don't cuss, and I always on people like, you know. That's why I tell people stop always using replacement cuss words and stop always using harsh words because it's easy for you to slip into cuss. I just don't cuss. We just don't cuss. And so when the cuss words come in my head, it's not my fault because I'm righteous minded and not sin minded.
Yeah.
That's like the Bible says. There's therefore no condemnation of them that are in Christ.
Yeah.
And so people always say, as long as you're in Christ and as long as you're doing things right, there's no condemnation. But boy, if you're not in Christ, there's but what he's saying is, it's not that he's not saying when he says that in the scriptures, he's saying that when there's no condemnation Now, once you're in Christ, there's no condemnation. Because now you're living according to the spirit of life in Christ Jesus. So there's no condemnation for us. And so we don't have to look and think in the condemned way at all. We don't think condemned. And thinking sin and perverted is condemned. And thinking about you're thinking about depression and thinking about being that God must, maybe I'm doing something wrong. Maybe something not working in my life because we're popping like it should pop. Things not happening like it should happen. I need to go fast. That is a sin-minded, condemned-minded person trying to make God do something for them. Because if you know your identity as a child of God, none of my children go fast and pray so that they can, you know, come to us about anything.
Right.
Gabby is the youngest. She just comes to us.
Lord, yes.
She don't go and fast and pray, mommy, daddy, don't feed me today so I can be worthy to be your child or something like that. No, she knows our responsibility as a parent. We have to take care of her. Yes. And so what we do is, we, if things not rolling in our life like we think it should, yeah, we always want to go fast and pray and let me get with God about
we
this
still
because
got
something
that
wrong.
Adam and Eve complex to run and hide and go run from God and you know.
Or
and,
we just, if we don't run, if we're not running from them, and because we don't have a revelation of our identity, we're trying to bribe him and trying to mush him up through religious activity, fasting, praying, well, God, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna start spending an hour with you every day. That's not what he's not trying to find someone to bargain with him.
Right.
To find out why something is not working or make something work. However, as his child, you can say, Lord, I'm going to spend time with you every day. At 6 o'clock, I'm going to get up every day and for an hour, I'm going to pray about this thing. Get your mind on this thing. That's totally different from saying, God, I don't know, something must be wrong. I'm going to see what's going on. I'm going to fast and believe you every morning that you're going to talk to me. You're coming from a different mentality.
Right.
And that's not a faith or a righteousness mentality.
It's not the stuff that you do to try to get favor with God.
You already have favor with God.
We just are favored. Yes.
We already have favor with God. We already are blessed.
So we can't try to manipulate God into doing something. You know, most people, I like how you said one time, a lot of people, when you start trying to fast to get God to do something, you're just going on a hunger strike.
Yeah.
You might as well just go eat.
Listen.
Go eat, please.
I don't do that. I don't even do no, we're going on a 40-day fast, church. No, I don't do that no more. Unless the Lord say it, because I used to do stuff like that because traditionally it's Lent time. We gonna fast 40 days. Choose what you're going to fast. First of all, we not Catholic, so I'm not celebrating Lent because Lent is not even biblical. It's not even in the Bible. I mean, it's
in your pocket.
You know, Lent. Yeah, Lent is not. So we do stuff like
so
that. You know,
that
yes,
we're going
to do this Lent before Easter and everywhere. And we're going to believe God on the day of resurrection. I mean, cool. There's nothing wrong with it if you want to fast. But practicing something out of religion after a while is just that, a practice of religion. And everything. I mean, because Mardi Gras is right before Lent. They have Mardi Gras, then they have Lent because they get all of their flesh out, they do all that little sin, and then they get eaten, then they go have Lent. That's what Mardi Gras is during that time, right before Lent, because Catholics is big down there in New Orleans. You know, they call them parishes instead of counties.
New Orleans,
they call them parishes instead of county because it's such a Catholic place. Everybody Catholic in New Orleans. And like they talk. But what I'm saying is this, that we get to a place of religiosity and always bribing God. When you don't know who you are, you're going to have to bribe him because you're not going to have coming with the confidence of a child, coming to the confidence that's my father, having that confidence that,
ooh,
you know, that I watch this, listen to this, that I deserve this. See,
ooh,
if people take that, ooh, I mean, now because listen
that
to this,
right there,
listen
what
to
you
this,
said, what
for,
you said.
Look, 2 Corinthians 5:21, we all know it. For he who knew no he was made to be sin who knew no sin, that we might be, listen to this word, made to be, that we might be made the righteousness of God. Not that we might work to get it, but but Jesus, who knew no sin, he was made to be sin. Boom. He didn't sin. Jesus didn't commit one act of sin, but he was made to be sin because he was the propitiation. He was the sacrifice God, what God demanded for sin. He was that he did. But now he says, I'm going to be made to be sin. So now you can now be made to be righteous. Now, hold on. Hold on. Listen, if Jesus never sinned and all of a sudden now he takes on the sins of the world and he is made to be sin, even though he never sinned.
Right.
Our sins was accounted unto him. Now listen, when we're made righteous, even though you may not have done nothing righteous, all of his righteousness is accounted and imputed on you. Now you have a son. Yes. You have this Jesus's righteousness on you, as if you were, as if you had acts of Jesus yourself. You are now going to be treated righteous. Listen, to the same degree that Jesus is now treated Ooh. Righteous. Ooh. Like Jesus was treated like sin, to the same degree that we was treated like sin. You were made now righteous.
Yes. Ooh.
So now they say, what's righteousness? Righteousness is not just right standing with God. It is, though.
It is that.
Because when you're righteous, you're in right standing with God now. Yeah. So therefore, you qualify. So because we are righteous now, there's like people say, man, you qualify and you deserve all God has for you. And then people always say, I mean, remember, only because of Jesus. They like to qualify all the time.
Yeah,
but now,
told you.
But now, remember, righteousness just doesn't have to in the kingdom. You know, everybody talking about something. We kingdom. You can't. If you kingdom, then you understand when I say righteousness. If you really a kingdom person and understand and got the revelation of kingdom, then you, when I say we are righteous, that means you understand. Yeah, doc, I understand. No, because you said doc, so you don't understand. If you said doc, you don't understand. That's good. No, because when somebody say righteous,
sir, you're out. Because you know,
all religious preachers just say doc all the time. Oh, you're the religious brothers and churches and church of God in Christ and church of this and church
that. Who voted that in? The same one. Who is this?
Like a bunch of
buddies.
Yeah, like we're a bunch of
buddies.
What's up,
doc? What's up, doc? You need any carrots?
I don't look at my watch.
Like 12.
What time?
11:59.
So let me tell you this: when I say righteousness, if you are kingdom minded, you don't think like we think. You don't think like the world thinks, or like the religious people think of righteousness. You think of it as a kingdom. And when you look at the word righteousness or righteous or righteousness in the kingdom means this: citizenship. Mm-hmm. That now I am, now once I've been made righteous, I have two powerful ways that I can use this. Number one, now I'm a full son. I'm a son with full access to the same degree as Jesus. Joint heirs now. I'm righteous. That means I'm right with the family, like the prodigal son.
Yeah.
I'm in full favor with the Father, just like Jesus was, just like he was in full sin, even though he didn't sin.
Right.
And got the punishment for it.
Yes, he did.
I'm in full righteousness as a son, just like Jesus, and now I can get full reward because of it now.
That's right.
So now my reward is not based on nothing I'm doing. It's based on everything Jesus did. Mm-hmm. Because I'm a son in full benefits. And then kingdom says, as righteousness, I am a citizen. Mm-hmm. I'm a son and I'm a citizen now. And I'm a citizen. Watch. I'm a citizen of the kingdom. And when I'm a citizen of the kingdom, that means now a citizen, I have citizenship. That means I have rights. That means I'm in right standing. So so when you look at righteousness, you got to look at it like this. In kingdom and in family, you look at it, son with full access, just like Jesus. And I can be treated just like Jesus now, even though I didn't do none of this stuff Jesus did. Now watch. But in the kingdom, you look at it like this. I'm a citizen in good standings with the king. Because if you ever get in bad standings with the king in the kingdom, you dead. But now I'm a citizen. I'm righteous. I'm a citizen of that kingdom. And now I'm in favor with the kingdom. I'm in favor with the king. I have, I'm in right standings with him. So now I did not. So that's why I can't sin. I don't want to, you know, you sin. Sin is just not just, oh, you did wrong. But when you look at sin, it's transgression. Sin is transgression of the law. Right. Mm-hmm. So when you sin, what you do is we going to get done. When you sin, you transgress the law. Yeah. When it's going up, they want to hear it. Sin is transgression of the law. So that means when I sin, I break the law. Watch this. And then when I break the law, that means now if I break the law, you can get punished. Now condemnation can be open. So that's why you don't want to sin and live in sin, because it's transgression of the law. And if you break the law in the kingdom, you get in trouble. Now, that's just in the natural sense. But we're not worried. We're not concerned about that because you're righteous. Mm-hmm. If you're righteous, you're not trying to sin. Am I right about it?
Right.
But if you do sin, just repent, go by your way. But the thing about it, when you're righteous, that means you're in right standing. That means you have the right to everything. Listen to this, y'all. That country's constitution say you can have.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm a right citizen of America, I have a right to unemployment if I lose my job. I have a right to food stamps and welfare if I don't fare well. Mm-hmm. I have a right to get. I have a right for a grant. I have a right to prosper. I have a right to get a job. Every right of a citizen, according to the constitution of that company, of that country, I have a right to.
Yes.
And the constitution of the country of heaven is the word. So that means now that you're righteous,
yes,
you have a right to everything that this word says is yours. And the reason why you have a right to everything this word says is yours and can do everything this word says you can do is because you are who the word says you are. A kingdom citizen that's righteous in right standing with the king, a son with full benefits, just like Jesus. And I'm done. So I put the giving information up there so you can sow your seed to Paul and Tara Thompson, to the ministry, you know, if you want to, if you feel led to, if you got blessed by this, you can sow your seed. You know who you are. We come on like that all the time. Who you are, what you can do, and what you can have, and you can do what the word says. Well, we say that all the time,
mm-hmm,
and it just came up to talk about it. It just mm-hmm came up. So I pray you got something out of it. I pray it helps you without your identity. Next week we may deal with the same thing, because you can't exhaust this but so much.
True.
You can keep on going on and on and on and on, because we didn't have so much religion and a bunch of other stuff. So when I get on certain stuff, boy, it gets me going. Even if I could be feeling down, I could be going, yes, through stuff.
The word gets him going.
If I get talking about the word, or
as
if I
you
get,
can tell,
if I get talking about word, or if I get talking about money, or sales and stuff like sales, money, mm-hmm, business, I get worked up a lot of times. I like it's enjoyable. Yeah, preachers always get worked up when they talk about money. No, I ain't talking about. I'm not talking about greed and money. I'm just talking about how money works. I'm talking about from business to sales to exchange to talking about stuff like that. That stuff, it's enjoyable. I enjoy that. But anyway, we pray that you really did get something, that it did make you think. The gospel should help you think. It should make you think. It should make you strive for more. So we pray that it causes you to strive for more. We pray it causes you to really begin to want to just dive in the word and kind of, mm-hmm, just start researching. Who am I? I know I'm saved, but let me, why don't you do this? Here's an exercise to do. Go in the New Testament and literally start looking up every scripture that talks about in him, in whom, and all that stuff. Because in him, in whom, by whom, and everything, it's all stuff that's talking about you, you know, in, yeah, whom we have redemption and stuff like that. You know, you are the righteousness of God in Christ. That is talking about
I'm
you.
Sure, sure.
So look up those scriptures where it's talking about in Christ, in whom, in him.
Yes.
Because it's talking about you, and it's giving good promises that you can just meditate on. And so build yourself up in who you are. And as you build yourself up in who you are, it's going to help you to contact what is yours, and it's going to empower you to do what you can do. And I believe that with all, yes, my heart. So, yes, so go and do that exercise. It'll help you out, the spiritual exercise. It'll be a blessing to you. You know, we got natural exercises and we got spiritual exercises. I'm going to get on that elliptical this evening. It's a natural exercise. I'm speaking it by faith. And so Thank y'all for watching today. Listen, again, didn't I put the the give me information is on the screen. And thank you for watching on today. Real quick, we're gonna get ready to sign off of this thing, and I'm gonna get ready to get behind the camera, and my wife will invite you to be a partner before we get off and everything. So I can turn this off and I'll leave that part blank so my wife can do that and give me a chance to turn the thing off there. But before we sign off, do you have anything to say?
No.
You sure? Positive? Mm-hmm. You sure?
Yep, sure.
She making the face like she really don't, but you know, I'm just gonna go ahead and stop now. You know what I'm saying?
No.
Well, y'all, this is Paul. I forgot my name. This is Paul and
Tara
Thompson. And with God, all things are possible. Peace.
I have nothing to say. We'll see you next Monday. You're going to cut me off now. Huh?
We will partner with us.
Okay. We believe in God for Kingdom Advancers. We would love if you would partner with us. We want you to be one of our faith partners and help us to advance the kingdom. So if you would, please make sure you inbox us, let us know. Listen, I already consider myself a kingdom advancer, or I want to be a kingdom advancer. And let us know that you are interested in being a covenant partner. We want to make sure that we invest in you monthly, and we're asking that you invest in us monthly by making that exchange of your carnal goods. Amen. And help us. We believe in God. We want to get across this country and go out and share the gospel. We want to go and do some things in a few different states, we've said. And maybe you know somebody that needs that needs to hear the word and hear teaching like you've heard today, and like that you know that we can do, especially that he can do. And we want to go out and minister to people. So help send us there. So be a kingdom advancer with us, and just give us that information. You can give us your email in our inbox or our personal inboxes, and just let us know, and we will be in contact with you. God bless you. Thank you for sowing and just entrusting us with so much in your life, and let us know how we can pray with you. God bless you, and see you next week.